Today, we look inside a failed LED light fixture. In my area, LED lights have started hitting the dumpster, which is good news to me, as I'm quite happy to investigate those to better understand their design and internal working. The LED light fixture I found was produced in 2018. Could be bought at my local home improvement store and claims 56 watts of power. Let's first check what happens when we plug it in. Who knows? Maybe this video gets suddenly exciting. Nothing. Time then for some unboxing. The lamp uses two strings of 56, 28, 35 types LEDs, making up for a total of 112 LEDs. A close inspection of the LEDs shows nothing special. Let's now investigate the power adapter. There again. Looking at the power supply does not show anything special. No burst capacitors. No burnt components. But wait. There is another side. OMG. We have found the problem. This is definitely toasted. Searching for this model of light on the internet revealed several people complained of early failure of those lights. So suspect the power module was not of the best design to begin with. But I'm not gonna worry about the power module since I'm more interested about the LED strips. Those can be reused since have been tested fine. The puzzle with LED lights is always figuring out the right power they will require. Especially because power requirements per LED can be confusing. So let me explain my findings. The light is rated at 56 watts and has 112 lights. The individual power per LED should therefore be half watt. So we are dealing with the half-watt version of the 2835 package, which should typically requires between 100 to 150 milliamperes of nominal drive current. The light is built of 2x56 LED strips connected in series. And each strip is made of 2x28 LED in series, so connected in parallel. Counting 3 volts and 150 milliamperes per LED. We should be able to drive the lamp with a 300 milliampere 168 volts power supply that I do not have. But I have other plans to make it work, so more to come in future videos.